welcome to this new episode of our program, The Beat. Well, as we promised you, we're gonna get to each single tiny megabeat happening on our beautiful land in Egypt. So please stay tuned with us as we will be back right after this. The beats. Welcome back. Well, tonight we are in El Sawi Cultural Wheel, which is situated in Zamalek, and to be more precise, in the Wisdom Hall, to bring you a very spectacular event, which is the concert of the brass section, the whole brass section of a group, El Nafiha. Let's watch. Well, I have the pleasure tonight to interview with me Mohammed Sawah, the trumpetist and the leader of Al Nafiha group. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
So I'll go back a little, or actually a lot. When did your love for the trumpet start?
That was very early. I had like 9 years old. Then I went to, I was actually liked, I love to sing and I love music in generally. I didn't know that I would be a trumpet player, but I went to the Cairo Conservatorium. Then I just see that they told me choose one instrument, how you like it, how the sound, how you find the sound. Then I choose directly the trumpet, and I started, was 9 years old, and now I'm 33.
You know why I'm asking? Because usually people, when they are kids, I mean, their parents make them, direct them to piano, to maximum to violin. So a trumpet was not an easy instrument for a kid. So how would you describe your own instrument?
Well, it's actually that this instrument, it's maybe it's a blowing instrument and wind instrument, and it needs really to find a way that you can really be, how can I say, sporty, or they see that your body is really strong enough to blow in that instrument. But for me, I find that this instrument is quite different, because it's really what you when you blow or when you play, you just find the sound has things from you, from your physical, from your body. You know what I mean?
Yes.
It's more like singing. It's more like something really belongs to you. It can describe the smallest thing inside your feeling. You know?
We'll be right back. So how could you describe the position of the trumpet amongst other brass instruments?
The position.
It's a solo
instrument. Yes, it is. It is a solo. It is one of the highest brass instruments frequency. And almost, I see it as a female. And I see, yes, I see it as a female. And she's usually she's the highest. And she's more to solo, more to the bright sound that can sing. But with the nafija, we are trying to do the same with the trombones and the bass tuba. That's what we are trying to work on, that the trombone can really sing and can sing oriental, and that's especially quite so different, and the first time happens in Egypt. That's what we are trying to do.
So, back to nafija, tell me more about the beginning of the group and the formation.
Yeah, that was a very beautiful story. We had just like... I'm working with my own project is how I can play oriental trumpet with a quarter tone, and that was my own project. Then I start to find a way to just collect like five instruments and like a classical quintet section, and then why not to start to play our classic music, Arabic music, and start to write down the music. And then my friends really was like, they was really happy with that. They really start to help and they really start to push. And then we start to work, and then we find a good sound, then we start to say, okay, we're gonna continue.
when you were beginning or forming the band, weren't you afraid from the Egyptian audience that all the instruments more or less are brass instruments?
Yes, that's true. I was really afraid and I was really frightened from the, was really scary about how we can, how the people are going to find the brass instruments playing Umm Kulsum and Abdul Wahab. And, you know, it was really a big challenge. But yes. once the audience start screaming and say, oh, and we start to freely, because that was like 1 year writing and 1 year rehearsing and, you know. So once it happens, we said, okay, we're going to continue. Congratulations, everybody. People start to like it, and that's all.
The aim of Nafiha musically?
Well, the aim is we are looking for Oriental brass sound. That's the main thing. Second thing to introduce our historical music and our traditional sound to the young people. That's also something else, and to invest this brass sound in the musical scene in Egypt, because it's almost disappeared. Mm-hmm. So we would like to make it alive again and to show the people what this instrument can do, and then they start to play it and they start to like it, and then, you know,
yes.
That's what I mean.
So you're presenting to us the beautiful and rich heritage of music, of Egyptian music, in 100 years. Tell me more about it.
Well, it was like the main idea that was we are thinking about to present our music. And then we say, why not if we take like every 10 years, we find like a superstar in 10 years, like, for example, Abdul Wahab, Sayed Darwish, Umm Kulsoom, Muhammad Fawzi, Abdul Halim. Then we start to say, why not that we can start just from the oldest to the newest. Then we just jump by 10 years. Then we have like a full repertoire with full of stars, and musically people like that. And I think that's kind of important music to rearrange.
Yes.
Because they were almost at that time, at them time, these people was almost the highest composers and like this.
To the end of this special episode of The Beat. However, there will be a part 2 for it, a continuation, so please stay tuned till next week, and until then, feel the beat.